In this video, I am going to explain the most important part of substation, that is transformer. Here we will discuss 31.5 MVA, 132 bar, 33 kV transformer and its parts. And also we will see some live transformer humming sounds. And next we will see control panels of transformer. And next the most important part of substation, that is automation. So by using automation, how we can control and how we can see the transformer parameters in our system. So let's start our video. What is a transformer? Transformer is a static device which does not have any rotating parts, and it transfers electrical power from one circuit to another circuit by changing its voltage levels and keeping its frequency constant. Now let's move on to transformer parts. The outer part of transformer is called a tank. Inside of tank, basically we have magnetic core, windings and transformer coil. Magnetic core. The main purpose of magnetic core is to provide low reluctance path to magnetic flux. Windings. These two are called windings. The winding which is connected to source is called primary winding. Here 132 kV side is source, so we call it as a primary winding. The winding which is connected to load is called secondary winding. Here 33 kV is load, so we call it as a secondary winding. Transformer oil. It is highly refined mineral oil. It is stable at high temperature and it has excellent insulation properties, and it carries away the heat produced in the core and winding. So it serves mainly two purposes. One is insulating medium and second one is coolant. Radiators or cooling tubes. The transformer has mainly two types of losses. One is core losses and second one is copper losses. Due to these losses, heat is produced inside of transformer which should be dissipated properly. Otherwise, it may damage the transformer. So, to dissipate the heat properly, we use radiators. Hot oil moves to upper portion of main tank. Then, this oil enters into the radiators through the top valve. And from top portion, it moves to bottom valve through thin seats. These thin seats exposed to outside atmosphere, so oil dissipates its heat and comes back to transformer through bottom valve. This type of cooling system is called oil natural, air natural cooling system. Here you can see how much thin radiator seats are. Heat dissipation rate of radiators can be increased by using fans, which means force air. These fans are fixed to radiators banks, and all fans must face towards the radiators. This type of cooling system is called oil natural air force cooling system. Now we will see some live transformers. This is a 160 MVA, 220 bar, 132 kV live transformer. The rating is more compared to previous one. So, if you observe the cooling system, the number of cooling banks are more. And here fans are fitted in bottom of radiators. And now here you can listen the humming sound like. This is mainly due to magnetostriction. And we will see one more live transformer. This one is very old, 100 MVA, 220 bar, 132 kV transformer. Here the humming sound is higher compared to previous one. Here radiators are connected away from the transformer, almost all old design transformers radiators are connected away from the transformer. Now come back to our 31.5 MVA, 132 bar, 33 kV transformer. Here is a mounting box connected to transformer. Now let's open it and see what is inside. Here you can see 3 meters on top portion. The first one indicates oil temperature, second one indicates HV winding temperature, and third one indicates LV winding temperature. Below you can see the contactors. By using these contactors we can connect cables from transformer to control panel. Now we will move to conservator. Conservator. The main purpose of conservator tank is to protect the expansion of oil in main tank. It is a cylindrical in shape and placed slightly higher level than main tank. Here you can see the conservator tank is connected to main tank through this pipe. As we know, oil expands with increasing load and contracts with decreasing load. When oil expands, the volume of oil in the main tank increases and it moves from main tank to conservator tank. So conservator tank acts as a reservoir. When oil contracts, it moves from conservator tank to main tank. Oil level indicator. This one is oil level indicator. It indicates the level of oil in the tank, and also it gives alarm when oil level dropped below certain levels. Breather. As we know, the transformer oil expands when it is heated. When the oil expands, the dry air in the conservator tank moves to the outside of environment through the breather. And when transformer oil cools down, air enters into the conservator. This air contains both dust and moisture. If you allow this air into the transformer, this moisture and dust reduces the dielectric strength of transformer oil. So we should have to stop the moisture and dust at entry point. This can be achieved by using a breather. Breather contains a silica gel which is blue in color. It absorbs moisture in the air and only dry air is allowed to conservator tank. Here, if you observe very clearly, a small cup with oil is there. So this oil collects the dust from air. Buck hose relay. Buck hose relay is used for the protection of transformer from the fault occurring inside of transformer. It is a gas operated relay and it is connected between conservator tank and main tank. Here you can see one more view of buck hose relay, how it is connected to conservator tank. Bushings. Bushings are basically provide insulation and these are used to connect inside transformer winding to outside circuits. Here you can see how LV bushings are connected to 33 kV circuits. These are HV bushings. The size of bushings is more because it requires high insulation, so because it is high voltage circuit. And these are oil filled bushings. We use oil filled bushings if rating is more than 33 kV. Here you can see how bushings are connected to 132 kV supply. I am making one more video on complete substation overview. There I will explain each and every equipment on of substation. Next, tap changers. It is very important to keep the consumer terminal voltage within specified limits. To keep secondary terminal voltage almost constant, we use tap changers. Tap changer is a device used for either increase or decrease the number of turns of transformer winding. So by using this handle and inserting this handle here, we can change the tap position manually, and by using this valve we can pump oil inside of transformer. And in case if you want to remove oil for any sampling purpose, so we can use this valve to remove oil from transformer main tank. Now let's move on to control panels of transformer. So basically, transformer has three control panels. One is RTCC and second one is HV side control panel, and third one is LV side control panel. Here you are seeing the RTCC control panels, which means remote tap changer, and here you can find the rating of transformer. So one is 18.9 MVA and second one is 31.9 MVA. So 18.9 is used when cooling is oil natural and air natural, and 31.5 MVA rating is used when cooling type is oil natural and air force type cooling. So here in bottom you can find some indicators. These indicators will indicate the fan positions, means whether the fan is on or off, and also whether fan control is in remote or manual control mode. Now let's move to downside. Here you can find a 3 meters. So these 3 meters will indicates the temperature and tap position. The first meter indicates both HV and LV winding temperature, and second winding indicates oil temperature, and third meter indicates the tap position of unload tap changer. Next, if you go down, you will find some annunciators. So these annunciator will give indication whether fan is failed. So here you can see fan 1 failed, fan 2 failed, and also it will tell so whether control supply failed or tap position is out of step or tap change is struck. So if you go down further, here you can find some switches. By using these switches you can control the unload tap changer tap position from control room. Now let's move to HV side control panel. So here you can find a differential relay. So this one is called differential relay. So by using differential relay we can protect the transformer in case any faults within the transformer. So we will see how we can protect. So let us say, so this one is 132 kV side and this one is 33 kV side. So transformer is connected through, so this one is 132 kV, so here is one CT, so another CT. So normally power current flows from this direction. So if current flows from the direction, so the direction, so through the CT, in this way. So in case if it goes in the direction, so similarly, so if it goes in this direction, so current flows from in this direction, or in this line here will go in this direction. So if you observe here carefully, so inside relay almost no current will flow. Why? Because so these two currents are almost same, so the relay will not operate. Why? Because the difference in current is zero. So in case if there is any fault within the transformer, means if there is a fault occurs in here, so then the current direction will reverse. So current flows from in this direction, here current flows from in this direction, so the direction of current is changed. So here, so the direction of current will flow in this way, 132 kV side and LV side, so the direction will change, so current will flow in this direction. So here you can find, so there is a current in relay, so the relay will operate and it gives trip signal to circuit breaker will trip the circuit and our transformer is safe. So next case, if you see, so in case if there is any fault in outside of transformer, this relay will not work. Let us say if a fault is occurring here in 33 kV side, so in this case current is flows same direction, so the current will flow here through CT in this direction, so here also current will flow through same direction, so the relay will not identify the fault and it will not send the trip signal to circuit breaker. So for such type of faults we will use one more relay, that is called overcurrent relay or earth fault relay. We will see. So earth fault relay or BAKE control protection relay, so this one is called earth fault relay or BAKE controlled unit relay. So this is the BAKE control protection unit. Here we will place overcurrent relay, so this relay will trip the signal, will trip the circuit breaker in case if there is any overcurrents in HV side or any earth fault in HV side. So if it goes down here, you can find so some control switches. By using these switches, so we can operate circuit breaker. Now let's move on to another panel, that is so LV side panel. So LV side panel, we have only one relay, that is overcurrent relay or BAKE control and protection unit. And next, here if you go down, you can find so some switches. These switches are LV side circuit breaker switches. We can operate from here on, from here also. And if you go further down, you can find some indicators. And if you go down, so here you can find 2 meters. By using these 2 meters, so we can read the energy what we supply to so distribution companies. Next we will move to the most important part of the substation, that is automation. Now let's move on to automation of transformer. So by clicking on the software, you will get the first window. This one is single line diagram of complete transformer, complete substation. So next video, I am making one video on complete substation. There I will explain each and everything. So here our part is only transformer, so I will concentrate only on transformers. So this one is incoming lines. These two are incoming lines, 132 kV incoming lines. Here one bus is there, this one is 132 kV bus. And from bus, so this one is called power transformer. So this power transformer will step down the voltage level to 33 kV. So this one is 33 kV bus. And these are all things are outgoing feeders, that is 33 kV feeders. So this substation is not charged. So here you will get everything in zero readings, all readings are in zero. So by clicking on this power transformer HV side, you will enter into the one more window. So this one is PTR one HV side. So here you can see the all measurements. So these are measurements related to phase, these are line to line, so these are line currents and power, reactive power, KVA power factor and frequency. So these signals are related to so differential protection relay signals. So here flux overflux trip signal also there. And this one is BCPU, BAKE control protection unit. So here you will find overcurrent protection and earth fault protection relay signals. And one more trip signals, PDR trip signals are backwards trip. So in case if there is any severe fault, so if it is identified the backwards, it will give directly trip signal to the circuit breaker and HV winding, on load tap changer trip, and oil winding temperature creep, so on so on. Next, this one is called PTR alarms. If there is any minor problems, so inside the transformer, so these will give the alarms. So buck was relay alarm, oil temperature alarm, next to winding temperature alarms. So here you can find the, so in bottom here you can find the temperatures of, so oil winding temperature, HV winding temperature and LV winding temperature. So from here, so from here, so you can raise the tap position of OLTC oil on low tap changer. So by clicking on tap changer, so you can raise the tap position. So and also here, so circuit breaker, so by clicking on this parameters, so you can trip the circuit breaker directly just by sitting on chair. So these are the main advantages of automation. So next we will move to LV side. So LV side, so LV side measurements, so these are all line measurements. So these are face to face, line to line measurements. These things are, so line currents and power, reactive power, yes, power factor, frequency. So these are all on secondary side, means 33 kV side. Here you will find only bay control protection unit, so that is overcurrent or earth fault signal. So overcurrent signals, next like earth fault protection. So you can trip the LV side breaker also by sitting in chair. So by clicking on this panel, by clicking on this parameter, so you can directly trip the circuit breaker. So by using automation, so we can see each and every parameter of substation, and also we can also control each and everything simply by sitting in the chair. So that is the main advantage of automation. Thank you for watching.